Oh, my name is my brother Eli, to welcome you back to another daily post of God's ministry. I'll start off with a prayer as I always do. Holy Spirit, we ask for your love, we ask for your grace, we ask for the spirit of the fruit to be here under the sound of my voice and to touch those under the sound of my voice. May the Holy Spirit work through people's homes, house, property, every aspect of their being that needs the word of God or the touching of the Holy Spirit. I ask that it be done. Do your will, Father Abba. And Jesus, just your mission. Now, Father, we thank you for your love and your peace and love and shalom that you have given us. And help us to remind us how to stay in it and to walk in it. Help us to be blessed in it. I pray that everybody in the sound of my voice is blessed. They have prosperity, love, and happiness, and joy, and family, and love, and joy. That people that's of you to entertain us into the word. That help us to have the community and love and support that we need. Father, I pray that you shower your children with love and peace and shalom and upliftment and give them the encouragement that they need to continue to go on. Father, I pray that you open up your children's eyes and ears so they hear what you want them to hear and see what you want them to see. I pray that you send your angels around and about them to protect them from physical harm, spiritual harm, protect them from sickness and illness, man-made and unman-made, known or unknown. Father, I pray that you release prosperity in the listeners' lives, so they're able to provide for themselves, their family, children, loved ones, give them the knowledge and the wisdom to spend the money wisely and to save and to harvest when they need to harvest, Father. In Jesus, Yeshua Mashiach's name, Father, I pray for excitement to touch the hearts of your children with the good news of the gospel and the good news that's coming in their lives. There's a lot of good news coming in people's lives, Father. And we know that the heavens are going to be opened up soon, as you start to crank up the heavens. In Jesus, Yeshua Mashiach's name, to open up the doors. I ask you to bless your children amazingly, continuously to help them to establish your children here on earth, continuously to help them to remember who they are, their position in the body of Christ, and who they are with you. Father, I ask you to help us to stand strong like soldiers, as we are ambassadors of Christ. May you continuously help us with our mission and help us to know who we are in your name, in Jesus, Yeshua Mashiach's name. Amen. Okay, I'm going to go into the teachings a little bit. Just wanted to say, Abba loves his children, as we know. He loves y'all dearly, and he wants you to know that nothing is wasted. Nothing. Not even one setback or delay is wasted. Everything was orchestrated and divinely orchestrated for a reason for you to, so you won't miss certain things that you may need to move on to the next level. There's a lot of people moving on to the next level. Abba wants you to stay ready. A lot of people moving on, whether you're moving physically or moving on to the next stage. A lot of shift going on around the world with Abba's children. A lot of shift. New people rising up. New ways of doing things. New everything. This is a definite different time, different atmosphere that we're in. So as we see, as things are wrapping up with the craziness that's going on in the world. So is Abba being revved up to rev up his children to take a stance on a stronger stance and a stronger understanding of how he operates in their life. So there's going to be a new ways of you learning things and going about things. I've been going through my little stages. I'm here and there. Abba has been showing me things and beautiful things that I never would have gotten if I would have rushed through the, trying to get where I know I'm supposed to be, but Abba causes a delay for everything. So it was a delay in your life too. So there's a lot of people who are being delayed and held back, not because of the enemy, because of what Abba was trying to do. But now that time has come full term, and now you know what you need to know, and Abba wants you to embrace the new. And ask him to help you to embrace the new, because sometimes it's hard to embrace something that's new, what we think and make. Take us out of our comfort zone. So ask Abba to help us to embrace it, embrace what it is he's trying to develop us in and to give us. But there's definitely a lot of people moving to the next stage. A lot of people moving physically. A lot of moves being done physically. So Abba saying prepare to move a new place, new home, new state, whatever it is. There's a lot of movement. Abba said he will provide for his children. The provision is needed. The provision is coming. So if you're thinking about moving or waiting, there's provision coming, and it's coming real soon. So he just wants you to be prepared. There's people moving and transferring from different jobs. Maybe you got hired or promoted to a different rank. But it's all for the Abba, because there are things in this world that you have what it takes to combat or to stay strong in those things and to be able to uplift others. So I'm going to get on with this teaching. Just fall into what Abba has given me. Peace. So it's 2 Corinthians chapter 3, verse 13. Let me read from there. And not as Moses, which put a veil over his face, that the children of Israel could not steadfastly look to the end of that which is abolished. But their minds were blinded, for until this day remaineth the same veil untaken away in the reading of the Old Testament, which is a veil is done away in Christ. But even unto this day, when Moses is read, the veil is upon their hearts. Nevertheless, when it shall turn to the Lord, the veil shall be taken away. Now, the Lord is the Spirit, and where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is liberty. Okay? So, there is a veil that the Abba want us to understand these things and how there's a veil over our hearts and minds that when it comes to understanding the law or the word of God, which is the law, the light that I'm talking about. He wants us to pray and ask him to ask to take away the veil from our face and hearts. So when we read the Bible, we see Jesus Christ of Nazareth, Yeshua HaMashiach, who is the finisher of the law. Okay? So he wants us to ask to remove the veils. Remove the veils off our hearts and minds so we're able to see Scripture the way he wants us to see Scripture. So we will not be of men of old who read Scripture and get lost, who doesn't understand the Word of God completely, and who may be confused. Because remember, we're going to have a lot of people who come into this world or who are in this world who's going to be deceivers of the Word, who's going to manipulate the Word to fit their agenda. And this has to do corresponding to the spirit of the Antichrist and people who are led by that spirit. So he wants us to be able to ask him to remove the veil from our face and hearts. So when we read the Bible, we see our Lord Jesus Christ in Nazareth, Yeshua HaMashiach, who's the finisher of the law. Okay, so also, the gospel is the light of the world. The word of God is the light. So I know you guys may not understand it fully, the word of God, the miracles that's performed by the word of God, the cream declaring the word of God. But as I read in 2 Corinthians chapter 4, verse 3, it reads again. I'm going to read it again so maybe you can catch on. But if our gospel be hid, it is hid to them that are lost, and whom the God of this world has blinded, the minds of which believe not. So we know the God of this world is Satan, and has blinded people. Blinded people, sometimes people don't even want to hear nothing from the Bible. They hate the Bible. They think the Bible is contradictory, and it's false, it's lies, and this is the reason why the world's like. There's so many things that people have invested so much hate for the Word of God, and it's because the God of this world is even written in the Bible, who is Satan. And it reads on, lest the light of the glorious gospel of Christ, who is the image of God, should shine upon them. So the gospel has light. I told you I had a testimony about the, I was reading the Bible one day and the words came alive spiritually. It was like a light that shined out of the Bible. It was so bright, it almost blinded me. From then on, I was on fire. I was up for like almost a week, just trying to get that thing back and to study the word. And then Abba shut me down. He's like, okay, I showed you a little bit. So there is a true light that comes from the word of God, and that's in this Bible that the enemy knows, and the enemy wants people to be blinded. And the enemy wants people to be turned off by the word of God, because that brings in lawlessness. That's what we have today. And the more people that go against this Bible, which a lot of institutions throughout the world were built through some of the cabinets and ordination of the word of God, now those institutions are being brought down because the spirit of the Antichrist and what's coming in the world is in the world is coming against that. And without that, we have lawlessness, the opposite of what God has spoken and wanted for us to have in this world. So Abba also wants us to act on saying, Father, I ask for the light of the glorious gospel of Christ to cover me, or to cover those who you're trying to preach or teach the Bible to. So the glorious light of the gospel protects people. Do it at your homes, your house. The glorious light of the gospel of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, Yeshua Mashiach, to cover people, things, or whatever it is. So the darkness that's in this world cannot touch it. And so also, the darkness, the enemy who is Satan, Lucifer, that's in this world, can no longer blind those who are held captive. So when you preach and teach the gospel to, they are able to be loosened until you're able to speak the word of God into them. Okay, so Abba wanted me to do that, to a little quick teaching, I'm sorry. But also wanted me to help you guys to see that there's really nothing to worry about. What's going on in the world, and there's a lot of fear. Abba also told me that there's different people in the world, in the government, who know they have plans to depopulate the world. It may not be as on the point where everybody was saying, but you know, they do have their plans. Abba also wants me to warn people as they're starting so-called to open up things back up in the United States, be very careful, because things are not what they say they are. Although there are people getting vaccine shots, it's going to be worse than ever. And Abba told me, he told me, those who look for the old will die in the old. And those who look for what things used to be, to try to go back to what things used to be, those are the people who's going to no longer be here. So we must not look to how things used to be in the world, because that world is being judged. And people are dying by the numbers when they try to go back and try to act like there's nothing going on, or nothing has happened, or nothing's going on at this time. So Abba wants you to be very aware and careful of going back to what things used to be normal, as they say. There's going to be another spike of coronavirus. A new virus is going to come in, Abba said. It's going to be another spike. It's going to be worse. And because the people that they feel like they have been vaccinated, that they're going to be okay. And there's going to be a lot of side effects. There's already reports of it, but there's going to be a lot of side effects. And people have to understand, about the control of everything, though, but he does give us warning, and he does give us insight. And we have to be able to stay in his word and his will for our lives, and to be able to be mature in the word. And even though we may think we know what's going on, we must also always, always stay at the foot of Abba, the Heavenly Father, our Lord Jesus Christ in us, and to stay strong in his word. And whatever he says is what he says. And try not to get caught up in what the world is saying, because there are two different things. There's the enemy that's in this world and the Abba's world. So there's two different worlds that's going on. Abba's world and the enemy's world. Abba's children and people are congregating together more than ever. And it's going to be split like that. It's going to be the world that everybody wants, what was used to be. You're going to hear a lot of death. It's not going to even come near you. It may come around you, but it won't come near you. And that's because you're not in that world. And you may feel things of that world because you're spiritually inclined and connected. So, but it's not on the level where you're being attacked spiritually. You may feel things, what's going on around the planet. Some may feel that because of their calling. And some may feel just things going on in their neighborhood. But it doesn't mean that you're being attacked. It's just because the level of flexibility that you are gifted to, gifted with in the spirit, and what Jesus has allowed. So I'm going to close this, and I'm going to pray for peace and love and shalom again. Father, I thank you for this. I thank you for God's ministry. I thank you for the people of God's ministry. I thank you for your son, Yeshua HaMashiach. I thank you for those who are blessed and you have your hands over them who come to listen to God's ministry. I pray that they uplift it. I pray that you console them, send your spirit of comfort to comfort all those under the sound of my voice, Father. In Jesus Yeshua HaMashiach's name. Father, I pray that you keep your children safe. Do not allow them to be tricked by the evil doers of this world and the evil plans that people have in certain agendas in this world. Protect your children. Watch over their family, children, and loved ones. I pray for good health, recovery, speedy, fast recovery of health. I pray that you are the medicine. The word of God is their medicine for protection and for healing and their vaccine. In Jesus Christ's name, Father, I pray for the blood of Christ to touch them, to uplift them, and strengthen their faith. I pray you give them the boldness and courageousness to continue to live life and to be on fire for you, Father. I pray that you engulf your children with the peace that surpasses understanding to guard their minds and their hearts, Father. I pray that you continue to heal those who are your children and continue to keep them in your world, Father. Help them to know the difference and to discern between Satan's world and your world so they stay in your world, Father, so they don't have to be in the middle or going between, so they know how to stay in your world. Help your children to stay planted in your world. Help them to see the spiritual discernment that they need, the spiritual line that draws your world from Satan's world. Help them to see that line, Father. In Jesus Yeshua Mashiach's name, I ask you to open their eyes so they can see and understand these things as you show me, Father, so your children are kept safe in that line. And when they're kept safe in that line, let them pray. Let them glorify. Let it be a knowing that they need to understand what's going on with themselves and the world so they stay protected from Satan's world. In Jesus Yeshua Mashiach's name. Okay, I thank you. My name is Mabali. I thank you for coming to another Daily Post of God's Ministry. Peace and Shalom.